Welcome to Spectrum Classes. This is our another lab experiment video, and in this video we are going to perform an experiment. Aim of the experiment is to determine the surface tension of a known sample using a stagmometer. So here we are having capillary tube, and so as we discussed earlier, any of the liquid forms a drop which is spherical in shape. And why it is spherical in shape? This is just because of the surface tension. It drops when weight of this drop is exactly equal to 2 pi r into surface tension. And here is the gamma. Gamma is the surface tension. It sometimes in some books it is represented by capital T. Here is the capillary. This is how a drop is falls. This is weight of one drop, fine. So to determine the density or weight, we need this density bottle. This is empty density bottle, and we fill it with liquid 1, take the weight. We fill it liquid 2, take the weight. Okay, so what is liquid 1 here? Liquid 1 is distilled water. Our liquid 2 is 10% glycerine solution. First I will tell you how to prepare the 10% glycerine solution. So in this measuring cylinder, fill up to the 10 ml. Here you can see the lower meniscus. This lower meniscus is one of the application of surface tension due to cohesive forces. I will pour this 10 ml into 100 ml. Wash it thoroughly with the solvent. Solvent is water here. And now I shake it well. Now I will make it up to 100 ml with the help of distilled water. So this is how one can prepare the volume by volume percent solution. So if we need 10%, so we added the 10 ml, or if we require 20%, so we add 20 ml of liquid. Here again we will read the lower meniscus. Fine. This we will transfer in the reagent water. This is our stagmometer. We require one rubber tube and one paper clip or some other clip, one beaker. This is burette stand. We will first fill it with liquid 1, that is our water. Here is my student. Okay, we first fill it and then we add rubber tube to this. You can previously also add this rubber tube to the stagmometer, and now we are just adjusting it to maintain the pressure, how the drop falls. So this rubber tube helps us to maintain the pressure. This is mark A, from where we have to start, and we read lower meniscus, and this is mark B. Up to this, all the drops. Okay. So here we adjusted the pressure. You can see we are also counting the number of drops. Part is the capillary part. The above this bubble, that is also capillary. You can see, and this drops have the spherical shape, and when it falls, when the weight of the drop is exactly equal to 2 pi r into surface tension. We stop it here. Now we will repeat the experiment. Here mark A, mark B, and we again adjust it with the help of rubber tube, and we count the number of drops. Here you can see. Now we will stop counting the number of drops when this is the lower meniscus is on mark B, right? And so here we just note down the number of drops which we have counted during the experiment for liquid 1 and liquid 2. We need to repeat the experiment 3 times and take the average of these, right? But since we have done this one time, so I'll just write here. Here is the W1 upon W2. So what is weight? Weight is equal to mg, mass into gravity. And this mass into gravity, mass, what is mass? Mass is equal to V into D, as you know. So here V1, D1. For W1, it is V1, D1 into G. And for W2, it is m2 G. And m2 is what? V2, D2 into G. G is the gravity, V is the volume, and D is the density for each volume. So since for both cases volume is same, so V1 is equal to V2, so V and G cancelled out. W1 upon W2 is equal to D1 upon D2. For n number of drops, we can have W1 is equal to 2 pi r, this is surface area, n1 gamma 1. W2 is equal to 2 pi r, n2 gamma 2. So what is W1 upon W2 here? W1 upon W2 is equal to n1 gamma 1 upon n2 gamma 2, because 2 pi r cancelled out. From this formula, n1 gamma 1 upon n2 gamma 2 is equal to W1 upon W2, and W1 upon W2 is equal to D1 upon D2. Now how we are going to determine this D? By using this density model. First we will initialize our electronic balance, and now we will weight the empty density bottle. This is perfectly dried, so this is the weight of the empty density bottle. We may note down this, or this is the weight of the empty density bottle. But we have facility to tear this, it now becomes zero. Whatever be the liquid we fill in this density bottle, we have the weight in the next measurement. First, I will fill this with 10% glycerin solution, and I thoroughly dry it from outside. Then now I will weigh this. So this is the weight of 10% glycerin solution. I'll just note it down. I'll just tell you why we have taken the weight of 10% glycerin first. Because glycerin solution, after transferring this glycerin solution to the reagent bottle, we have to wash it thoroughly. So we will again wash it with the distilled water 2-3 times. After washing it thoroughly, we need to fill the distilled water, so density will not get affected. So that is why we fill the liquid one if the second one is distilled water, or we need to dry it completely, right? Now we will take the liquid one, that is distilled water, in this density bottle and take the weight. So this is the weight of water. Okay, one more thing I'll just bring into your notice. This is very important for the student's point of view. In some of the density bottle, there is a mark over this. So you fill up to that mark and read the lower meniscus. If no mark is given, then this is having a small capillary over there. So you need to fill it thoroughly, and you just fill. So this is up to this much. So no need to worry about the level of the liquid. So two type of density bottles are there. So whichever is you are having, how to use that. Okay, so that is important. Here I can show you. You can see this hole. Okay, so this is a small capillary. We need to fill it up to this mark. This is weight one. This is weight two. Or we will solve the density using these weights. So weight we are already having, and density for water is a standard, which we are taking over here. Density is taken as 1 gram. It is 0.997, but we roughly take it as 1 gram, cubic centimeter. Either you can calculate the D2 first, or you simply put W1 upon W2 into the formula. So this is how you are going to solve this. That depends on you, right? So N1 is what? 61 for liquid 1. Gamma is its surface tension for water. It is 72, and this is at room temperature or at 25 degrees centigrade, right? At 20 degree, it is 72.8. Now N2 is 69 into gamma 2, that is surface tension for liquid 2, we need to calculate. And what is your D1 upon D2? So if you are writing, D1 is 1 gram per cubic centimeter. And what is your D2? So from here you can evaluate the D2, or you simply write down W1 upon W2 in the formula. This is how. Now we are going to calculate surface tension for liquid 2, or after solving we get 65.154 dynes per centimeter. This is the result. I hope you understand the experiment, how to perform and how to calculate the readings. And if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and give me a thumbs up. Thank you all.